الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، from the beginning of mankind, or from our father Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام, Iblis made it clear that he is our enemy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran. So it is very clear for us, and it is very easy for the believers to fight this enemy. Why? Because you know all of his weapons, and you know his aim and his goal. But this is for the believers who read the Quran carefully. Let's read what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about this enemy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us his aim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran about Iblis, the worst shaitan, what is his aim? لعنه الله وقال لأتخذن من عبادك نصيبا مفروضا ولأضلنهم ولأمنينهم ولآمرنهم فليبتكن آذان الأنعام ولآمرنهم فليغيرن خلق الله. Allah cursed the shaitan, for he had said, I will surely take from among your servants a specific portion. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said after that the shaitan said, and I will mislead them, and I will arouse in them sinful desires, and I will command them so they will slit the ears of cattle, and I will command them so they will change the creation of Allah. And who overtakes shaitan as an ally instead of Allah has certainly sustained a clear loss. Not only that, in the next ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَعِدُهُمْ وَيُمَنِّيهِمْ وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. He promises them and arouses desire in them, but shaitan doesn't promise them except delusion. أُولَٰئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ وَلَا يَجِدُونَ عَنْهَا مَحِيصًا. The refuge of those will be hell, and they will not find from it an escape. So this is the goal and the aim of our enemy, the shaitan. He made it clear for us. His goal is to misguide us. His aim is to destroy the mankind, to let them go in the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah. الشيطان, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. الشيطان threatens you with poverty and orders you to immorality. And some scholars said here, stinginess. The shaitan tells you when you are trying to give the charity, the sadaqah. Why? This is your money. This is for your health, for your car, for your family.
for your future. Keep this money for you. This is the shaitan. And he tells you, if you give charity, you will be poor. You will be in need. Then you will try to beg the people. شيطان يعيدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. This is the shaitan. And there is something very important mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, everything important in the Quran. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ Sorry. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا مِنْكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ إِنَّمَا اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بِبَعْضِ مَا كَسَبُوا Indeed, those of you who turned back on the day, this means, as the scholars say, the day of Uhud. In the battle of Uhud, when the Muslims lost the battle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us why. He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّمَا اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ بِبَعْضِ مَا كَسَبُوا On that day, the two armies, the army of the Muslims, with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the army of the kuffar. Two armies met. It was shaitan who caused them to slip because of some they had earned. Because of our sins. So the shaitan can trap the Muslim if he is doing the sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ Those who believe, they fight in the cause of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ الطَّاغُوتِ And those who disbelieve, they fight in the cause of طاغوت. Anything worshipped other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَقَاتِلُوا أَوْلِيَاءَ الشَّيْطَانِ So fight against the allies of shaitan. Then he said, which is very important, he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا The plot of shaitan has ever been weak. Don't fear the shaitan, he's very weak. How come he's very weak? He's doing all of these things. Yes, for those who are weak in iman, he will be stronger than them. But for the strong believer, the shaitan is very weak. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the shaitan. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu innama al-khamru wal-maisir wal-ansabu wal-azlam rijsun min amal ash-shaytan fajtanibuh la'allakum tuflihun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about these four major sins. Oh, you have believed. Indeed, intoxicants, gambling, son alert, altars, and divining arrows are but defilement from the work of shaitan. So avoid that. You may be successful. These are major sins. We have to avoid them. Haram, major sins. Then he said, he told us what the shaitan wants. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَن يُوقِعَ بَيْنَكُمْ الشَّيْطَان يُرِيدَ أَن يُوقِعَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ Shaitan only wants to cause between you as believers animosity and hatred through intoxicants and gambling, subhanAllah. So this is his aim. If you are fighting your brother or your sister, your friends, Muslims friends, this is because of the shaitan. Because we are following the shaitan, we are not saying A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. This is the aim of the shaitan. And be sure that this shaitan who's leading the people to the hellfire at that day, the day of judgment, will say, will give a talk. He will give a khutbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Surah Ibrahim, وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانِ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ وَوَعَدْتُكُمْ فَأَخْلَفْتُكُمْ Subhanallah. And shaitan will say when the matter has been concluded. It means khalas, after death, at the day of judgment. This time, no deeds. You don't work. You don't pray. No zakat. If you want to give zakat now, you want to fast now, you like to gain hasanat, now you gain hasanat. So at that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the shaitan. And shaitan will say, when the matter has been concluded, indeed, Allah had promised you the promise of truth. And I promised you, but I betrayed you. Allah told us, if you pray, you enter paradise. And at that day, those who prayed in dunya will be in paradise. So the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled. Where is the promise of the shaitan? The shaitan told our father Adam, أَرَدُكُمْ عَلَى الشَّجَرَةِ الْخُلْدِ وَمُلْكِ لَا يَبْلَى. Let me guide you, let me tell you about the tree of khuld, eternity. خلاص, you will live forever, you will not die. Okay, when Adam and Eve ate from the tree, they died. After 100 years or 1,000 years, they died. Where is the promise of shaitan? He betrayed us. So brothers, sisters, it is clear that the shaitan is a liar. He's misguiding us, misleading us, taking us astray. Don't believe the shaitan and believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what is going to happen at the day of judgment. Then he said, the shaitan, وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. سبحان الله, ما أنا بمصرخكم وما أنتم بمصرخي. The shaitan will say, but I had no authority over you except that I invited you and you answered that invitation. He means I did not force you to kill or to take the riba or to do the fornication. I did not force any one of you to do any sin. Subhanallah. Where is your promise? This is the shaitan. This is the shaitan. He said, I invited you and you answered my invitation. I told you, drink the intoxicant. Drink some wine. And you listened. You said, inshallah, hadir. Yes, I am ready for that. So, subhanallah, Allah mentioned about that in the Quran. مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخِكُمْ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِي. At that day, you are not going to help me and also I am not going to help you. You led us to do the haram things in this dunya. And now you forget us in the akhirah when we are in a big trouble. Yes. Because this was your option when you commit the haram. May Allah protect us from the shaitan. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. أما بعد, of course there are many things in the Quran and Sunnah to make us fear the shaitan, but we have to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ يُخَوِّهُ أَوْلِيَاءَهُ فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. This is the shaitan. This is the shaitan. That is only shaitan who frightens you of his supporters. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so don't fear them. Don't fear them, but fear me if you are believers. So this is the weapon to fight the shaitan. Don't fear the shaitan. Don't obey the shaitan. And fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fear, the real fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best protection from the plots of the shaitan. But if we fear the shaitan, we fear the future, the poverty, the hunger, then at the day of judgment, we'll be with the shaitan wa al-iyadu billah. But if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by obeying him, If you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the result of his fear. What does it mean to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To lose the hope? No, never. To work hard to achieve Jannah, paradise, by obeying him subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the plots of the shaitan. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات رب العالمين آمنا في أوطاننا أصلح ولاة أمورنا يا رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم اجعل هذا بلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.